नमस्कार, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी. मी शिव पोखरेल. माय चैनल योगा एंड फिटनेस विद शिव. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव अ वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट वीडियो स्पेशली फॉर प्राणायाम्स. आई एम प्रोवाइडिंग सम इम्पोर्टेंट प्राणायाम्स स्पेशली फॉर बिगिनर, दोज पीपल आर ट्राइंग टू प्रैक्टिस योगासना एंड प्राणायाम. डेफिनेटली दिस प्राणायाम विल हेल्प टू इम्प्रूव योर नॉलेज information and about the techniques. Therefore, if you are a newcomer in my channel, you can subscribe my channel, like my videos and comment on the comment box. If you feel this video is very useful for your friends, colleague and loved one, you can share this video. Let's start today's topics. First of all, what is pranayama? Prana means bioenergy and ama means regulation. To regulation our prana energy in our body is called pranayama. Therefore, it is not like as a breathing exercise. It is especially to regulation in our body. There are five prana. Among them, one is prana, second is apan, third is saman, fourth is uddayan, and fifth one is ban. To balance our all pancha prana, this pranayama plays a vital role. Therefore, you can practice after completing your asanas, then you can start this pranayama. After getting some knowledge about the pranayama, you can first of all you can do conditioning. Conditioning means to prepare our body, mind and soul, especially physically, mentally and spiritually. If you are directly go to the mat and apply to prime, that is not very good. Many things are coming in our mind. We cannot concentration over our breathing. Therefore, first of all, you can conditioning nearly 5 minutes. To do conditioning, I had provided many videos in my YouTube channel, in my social networks. You can watch that video completely. I am just describing about this thing. You can sit at any meditative yoga posture, Sukhasana, Padmasana, Vajrasana, any types of asana. I am sitting on the Padmasana. Then erect your spinal cord, chin parallel to the ground, navel tuck in, tailbone tuck in, chest on normal counter, and shoulder roll back. Make your hand any mudra or without mudra, you can keep your palm on the thigh. From here you can observe your breath. Deep inhale, exhale. You can chant Guru Mantra as well when your breath is balanced. When your breath is very long, there is no any jerky movement, you can do or practice Guru Varma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Satchat Paravarma, Tasmai Shri Guru Ve Namaha, Guru Varma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Satchat Paravarma Tasmai Shri Guru Ve Namaha. In this way you can chant 5-6 times, and you can chant Yogena Chitta, any types of mantras, and you can start some pranayams. First one is you can practice very important pranayam, that name is intercostal breathing. To do intercostal breathing, there is no any retention and suspension. You can bring your both hand, your palm, forefinger is outside, and your both thumb finger is behind your chest, and you can hold your intercostal muscle. If you inhale, hold your intercostal muscle is raised, and your elbow is also wide. When you exhale, your elbow is also in and your intercostal muscle also compress. Let's start. You can do this pranayama equal in ratio. If you take 3 second inhale, you can exhale 3 second as well. Let's start. Inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3, 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 inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3. You can practice this pranayama nearly 5 times, 10 times in a day, and you can do 2 rounds, 3 rounds. Then you can practice other important pranayama is clavicular breathing techniques. Clavicular means in our collarbone, first of all, keep your hand on the collarbone. Your thumb is behind, your forefinger is front, your elbow is out, elbow is very erect, and erect your spinal cord. From here, if you inhale, your rib cage is also up, and your both elbow is also little bit back, and when you exhale, your collarbone is also compressed, and both the elbow is also little bit or starting position. There is no any retention and suspension. You can do the in this normal breathing, and you can take inhale in 3 seconds and exhale is also 3 seconds. Inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3, inhaling 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3, inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3, inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3, inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3. This is also very, very beautiful yoga pose, especially pranayama. You can practice for beginners as well. This pranayama is also very good to those are not practicing very hard running, jumping. This is very helpful because in especially in our intercostal muscle is very rare use in our daily life. If we are running, jumping and hard exercise, there is muscle use especially for intercostal muscle. Therefore, you can practice this pranayama. Then other important pranayama is equal inhalation and equal exhalation. To do this pranayama, you can put your hand on your thigh, erector spinal cord, same position, and you can inhale your diaphragmic breathing, your intercostal breathing, and your clavicular, all the muscle is using. When exhaling, your all three muscle is using. Let's start. Inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3, 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 inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3. If you practice many times, you can you can increase your ratio, especially 5:5. I am only providing today's video especially for beginner. Therefore, I am practicing 3:3. This is also very good yoga, especially pranayama for beginners level. In this pranayama, all the muscle is using. Therefore, our efficiency to take breath in our body and out is also very good. And next other very important pranayama is you can lie down on the back and you can practice belly breathing or diaphragmatic breathing. Keep your knee together, your leg is a little bit wide. From here, keep your palm on the belly and keep your other hand on the mat, palm facing downward. From here, inhaling, your belly is out, exhaling, your belly is in. Especially in this pranayama, diaphragmatic muscle is using. Let's start. Inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3, 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 inhaling 1, 2, 3, exhaling 1, 2, 3. You can practice. There is no any retention and suspension. Anybody can practice this pranayama. you can practice, and again you can comment, and you can practice other very last and very useful pranayama. That name is Brahmari Pranayama or humming bee sound breathing technique. To do this pranayama, you can erect your spinal cord, same position you can sit at any meditative yoga posture. From here you can make yoni mudra, or you can keep your both index finger on your ear. From here inhaling, and when exhaling there is a sound coming, humming sound. Inhaling normal breathing and exhaling on the humming sound. You can practice this 5 times. Inhale. This is a very excellent pranayama. That name is Brahmari Pranayama. Especially this is very good to cool down our mind, especially to improve our nervous system. Then you can practice on Omkara, Om chanting at last, and I am going to finishing today's video. Thank you for watching my videos completely. We'll meet next day with next video. I am chanting Omkara. Ah.